Hi students, myself Babila Matthew. In this session, we are going to discuss about breach presentation. In breach presentation, the fetus lies longitudinally with the buttocks in the lower pole of the uterus. You can see from this picture, so buttocks in the lower pole of the uterus. It is the commonest malpresentation. So that is the breach presentation, buttocks in the lower pole of the uterus. The incidence, 3 to 4% of fetuses present by breach at term, and 5% at 34 weeks, and 20% at 28 weeks, and 20% diagnosed initially in labor, and 3.5% of term singleton deliveries are about 25% of cases before 30th week of gestation undergo spontaneous cephalivotion acute. These are the incidents. Next, we can see the causes. First, fetal causes. Prematurity, multiple pregnancy, anomalies of the fetus such as hydrocephaly, anencephaly, meningocele, and congenital dislocation of this hip. These are the fetal causes for the breach presentation. Next is the uterine, that is a bicornuate uterus and fibroid uterus. That also furtherly leads for the breach presentation. Then placenta. Placenta causes, that is placenta previa. So when the placenta is located in the lower segment, fetal head cannot occupy in the lower segment. So that's why the breach presentations occur because of placenta previa. Next is liquor, that is polyhydramnios. If the amount of fluid is more, baby will not occupy in the proper position. So that's why maybe sometime lead to the breach presentation. Then oligohydramnios also, baby cannot do the changes, that's why it may fix into the breach presentation. Then pelvic causes, that is a pelvic tumors, that also interfere in the cephalic presentation. Next we can see the varieties of breach presentation. You can see different types of breach presentation. So complete breach and full-limb breach. So in the complete breach, you can see from this picture, this is the complete, baby is sitting like a sitting position. That is full-limb breach, is the foot is also present. Foot is present in the lower pole. That is a full-limb breach is a presentation, but foot is also present. That is a full-limb or incomplete breach. In the complete breach, you can see this is the flex. This is here the legs are spread. You can see different position or different varieties of breach presentation. Next we can see the complete breach presentation or flex breach presentation. The normal attitude of full flexion is maintained. You can see this is the full flexion is maintained. The presenting part consists of two buttocks, external genitalia and 2 feet. You can see this is 2 feet. And consists of buttocks, both buttocks are present, and external, you can lower pole, you can see the external genitalia also. And the thighs are flex at the hips, and the legs are knees. You can see this is the flex, the thighs also flex, and the hips also at the hip and the knees also in the same manner. And it is commonest in the multi-parent woman. This is a complete breach. Next is the incomplete breach. This is due to varying degree of extension of the thighs or legs at the podiatric pole. So you can see one leg is extended. So that is the incomplete breach presentation. Next, incomplete breach presentation also comes in varieties. You can see different varieties of incomplete breach presentations. The first is frank breach. It is breach with extended legs. You can see both legs are, this is like this. You can see both legs are extended. This is breach with the extended legs. Both legs are in the upper portion. Breach with extended legs, where the knees are extended while the hips are flexed. Hips are flexed, but knees are extended. More commonly, it occurs in the primary gramina. Next, second position is in incomplete breach in full-limb presentation. The hip and the knee joints are extended on one or both sides. You can see hip or knee joints are extended one for both sides. You can see one is extended and more commonly preterm singleton breaches is usually occur in the footling. One foot is outside. It is a footling presentation. Next is the knee presentation. Same as in the footling presentation. This is knee. Baby like a it's flexed knees. Okay. The hip is partially extended. The hip is not flexed. It is partially extended. And the knees is flexed on one or both sides. You can see this is flexed knees. This is the knee presentation. Incomplete breech presentation present or frank breech, footling presentation and knee presentation. Next we can see the different clinical varieties, that is uncomplicated and complicated. Uncomplicated means it is defined as one verb, there is no other associated obstetric complication apart from the breech. That is no other complication will be the only breech presentation is only the problem, and prematurity is being excluded. Then complicated presentation means when the presentation is associated with conditions which adversely influences the progresses such as prematurity, twins, contracted pelvis and placenta previa. There's other complications, that's why it is known as complicated breech presentation. These are the clinical varieties of breech presentation. Next we can see the etiology of breech presentation. So the main etiologies include prematurity, factors preventing the spontaneous abortion, favorable adaptation, undue mobility of the fetus and fetal anomaly. That's first we can, first is prematurity, second is factors preventing the spontaneous abortion. So what are the, we can see what are the factors that preventing the spontaneous abortion. Usually it is spontaneously abortion happen and cephalic or head will come down. But some factors that may prevent the spontaneous abortion, that are breech with extended legs, twins, oligohyjamnios, congenital malformation of the uterus such as septate or biconiate uterus, short cord, relative or absolute, and intrauterine death of the fetuses. That are the factors that prevent the spontaneous abortion. Next is the favorable adaptation, that is due to hydrocephalus. The big head can be well accommodated in the wide fundus. Fundus is wide, so when baby is hydrocephalus baby, it is favorably adapt in the fundus. Head is adapted in the fundus. Then placenta previa, we already explained placenta previa. The placenta is the lower segment. The fetal head cannot accommodate in the lower segment, so it will go up and breech presentation will occur. That's other, and also the contracted pelvis and corneofundal attachment of the placenta. These are the favorable causes or adaptation that causes help for the breech to adapt in the lower cord. Then undue mobility of the fetuses, that is hydramnios, that is it will be mobile freely, that is the undue mobility of the fetus. And the hydramnios, that is a more fluid is more and multiparative with lax abdominal wall. When the abdominal wall is lax, more room space is there, so baby will be undue mobility of the fetus will occur. Next is a fetal anomaly, that is trisomies 13, 18, 21, and then cephaly and myotonic dystrophy due to alteration of fetal muscular tone and mobility. That also causes the breech presentation. These are the etiology of the breech presentation: prematurity, factors preventing the spontaneous abortion, favorable adaptation, undue mobility of the fetus, and fetal anomaly. Next is the how can we diagnose. So there are three methods also can be adopted for the diagnosis. First is clinical, sonography and radiology. Each one we can see in detail. In clinical, per abdomen, we already know how we can assess in the abdominal, that is fundal gait, lateral gait, pelvic gait and FHS. Fundal means fundus, lateral gait both sides. pelvic grip means lower quad and FX. So in the fundal grip, if it is complete, head suggestive of heart and globular mass and head is bilateral. But in Frank Beach, head irregular, small parts of feet will, because feet also present in the upper portion. So that's why irregular small parts of the feet may be felt at the side of the head. And head is not bilateral due to splitting action of the legs or the trunk. And next is the lateral grip in sideways. How? The breech suggestive of a soft, dull and irregular mass. Then small, hard and conical mass is felt in the frank breech. And the pelvic grip, the breech is usually not engaged due to pregnancy. Okay. Then breech is usually engaged in the frank. And FH is usually located at the higher level round about the umbilicus. Okay. But in the frank breech, it located at a lower level in the midline due to early engagement of the breech. So this is about the abdominal assessment. Next is the purvagina. That is, during pregnancy, soft and irregular parts are felt through the fornix. And frank breech, hard feel of sacrum is felt over mistaken for the head. Then during labor, palpation of ischial spine, ischial tuberosities, sacrum and the feet by the sides of the buttocks also can be palpated. And the foot felt is identified by the prominence of the heel, lesser mobility of the great toe. Then in the frank breech, palpation of ischial tuberosities, anal opening and the sacrum only. So this is about the clinical assessment by complete breech and the frank. Next is ultrasonography. We can see what are the findings, for what things we are doing the ultrasonography. It confirms the clinical diagnosis, especially in the primary gravida with engaged frank breech or with the tense abdominal wall and irritable uterus. Then it can detect fetal congenital abnormality and also congenital anomalies of the uterus. And next, type of breech, that is complete or incomplete, can be assessed. And it measures biparietal diameter, gestational age and approximate weight of the fetus. And it also localizes the placenta and assessment of liquid volume. And is very important for the external cephalic motion. So ultrasound helpful for all these purposes. Next is the radiology. To confirm the clinical diagnosis, to exclude the bony congenital malformation, to know the size of the baby, to know the position of the limbs and head. This is the radiographic effect. Then we can see the during pregnancy, how can we assess them. For the inspection, a transverse groove may be seen above the umbilicus. You can see there will be a groove, can be transversal groove can be seen in the umbilicus in the sacral anterior, corresponds to the neck. In the neck portion here, in the head and the breech, in the neck portion, there is, we can see a groove in between. If the patient is thin, the head may be seen as a localized bulge or in the one hypochondrium. So in the any one hypochondrium, we can see a bulge of fetal head. In palpation, this is the palpation. You already know fundal palpation, lateral palpation and pelvic palpation. So in the fundal grip, the head is felt as a smooth, hard, round, bilateral mass which is often tender. Then umbilical grip, that is the back is identified and has a depression. Next up, in the first pelvic grip, the breech is felt as a smooth, soft mass continue with the back. And child to do ballotment, the breech shows that the movement is transmitted to the whole channel. Auscultation, FHS is heard above the level of umbilicus, however in Frank Bridge, it may be heard at or above the level of umbilicus. You can see this is the positions. You can see this is the position usually seen in the breech presentation. So right or left, sacro posterior, right sacro anterior here. This is the right sacro posterior position. Right or left, sorry, right or left sacro anterior and posterior positions. Next is the positions. There are different forms of positions. Our first position is the left sacro anterior. This is here, if we can feel like a, if it is a pelvis, so this is the right sacro anterior. You can see from here, this is the okay. So this one here, this is the right sacro anterior. So sacrum touches the right iliopectinal index. Then left is, that is first position. Second is first position is the left sacro anterior. Here is the left sacro anterior. Then sacrum touches the iliopubic eminence, and this is the right sacro anterior, the second position. So sacrum touches the iliopubic eminence, and third position the right sacro posterior. So sacrum points towards the back, that is the sacroiliac joint. And the fourth position is the left sacro posterior, that is the here sacro iliac joint, left side. It touch, sacrum touches the sacroiliac joint. Okay, that's the position. And also comes at left sacro transverse and the right sacro transverse, and sacrum anterior, this is the posterior. So these are the main positions. Okay, four positions, and also this position sometimes occur. So mainly these four positions usually occur. Then we can see the mechanism of labor in the breech presentation. So for, there is three steps of delivery. Delivery of the buttocks, shoulder and the head. So first we can see delivery of the buttocks. So engagement take place in the diameter of trochanter. This is the bitrochanteric diameter, 10 cm enter the pelvis with the one oblique diameter, any one oblique, and descent buttocks occurs until the anterior buttocks touches the pelvis. Then interrotation of the anterior buttocks occurs through the 1/8 of circle placing behind the symphysis pubis, and further descent takes place, and then by the lateral flexion trunk occurs until the anterior hip hinges under symphysis pubis and the release first, followed by the posterior, and delivery of trunk and the lower limbs also follow, and restitution occurs so that the buttocks occupy the original position as during the engagement, so it return back to previous position. Next is the bisacrum. This is the shoulder bisacrum diameter, that is 12 cm engages in the same oblique diameter as in the first when occupied the buttocks at the brim soon after the delivery of the breech. After the delivery of the breech, bisacrum diameter also engages the same diameter of the buttocks. Okay, then descent occurs and internal rotation of the shoulder, bringing the shoulder to lie under the anteroposterior diameter of the pelvic outlet. The trunk spontaneously rotates extended through the 1/8 of the circle. Same time back, this trunk also extended. Internal rotation occurs, same time external rotation of the trunk also occurs. And the delivery of the posterior shoulder, followed by the anterior shoulder blood, and accompanied by the anterior flexion of the delivery of the trunk, and restitution occurs to the same position. External rotation occur. Next is the delivery of the head. Head engages through either to the opposite oblique diameter that is occupied by the buttocks. If it is this one, opposite oblique diameter of the buttocks to the transverse diameter. The engaged diameter head is suboccipital frontal diameter of 10 cm engages and descend with the increased flexion. Occurs, and when the occiput occurs, occiput rotate, internal rotation of the occiput rotates anteriorly 1/8 of the circle. If it is transverse, 2 by 8, otherwise 1 by 8 of the circle. If it's oblique, then 1 by 8 of circle. Place the occiput behind symphysis pubis. So for same time, external rotation of the body also take place, and back is in the uppermost position. And further descent occurs until the subpubic hinges under the symphysis pubis. And head is borne by the flexion. That is, you can see, this is by the flexion. You can see, this is different manoeuvres are used. We can see later on. Chin, mouth, nose, forehead, vertex are appearing successfully, and by the and occiput is borne by the moment of flexion, and depend the injury upon the bearing force and not at all on the uterine contraction. Okay, and sacroposterior flexion, the mechanism is not substantially modified. The head has to rotate through 3 by 8 of circle to bring the occiput behind the symphysis pubis. So that's all about the delivery mechanism of labor. Next we can see the complication. The material complication include operative delivery, including cesarean section, perineal and cervical laceration, bleeding due laceration and infection. These are the maternal complications. Next is the fetal dangers: intrapartum fetal death, intracranial hemorrhage, birth asphyxia. It is due to cord compression soon after the buttocks has delivered, and also when the head enter into the pelvis, the period of more than 10 minutes will produce asphyxia of varying degree. So when the breech is delivered, the cord is hanging there, so it will compress, so that is a that causes the birth asphyxia and delayed delivery of the head and cord prolapse. This all causes the birth asphyxia and birth injuries, such as hematoma over the sternomastoid or over the thighs, and fractures. The common sites are femur, humerus, clavicle and odontoid process. Then there may be dislocation of the hip joint, mandible or fifth or and sixth cervical vertebrae, and epiphyseal separation. So these are the fractures occur. Next, visceral injuries include rupture of the liver, kidney, suprarenal glands, lungs and hemorrhage in the testicles. These are the visceral injuries. And nerve include medullary conning, spinal cord injury and stretching of the brachial plexus to cause either herbs or clunky's palsy. You all studied all these injuries or birth injuries in the newborn birth injury topic, and long-term neurological damage. So these are about the fetal dangers. Next, how can we prevent the fetal hazard? The incidence of breech can be minimized by external cephalic abortion. Is possible, were possible if abortion fails or is contraindicated, delivery is done by elective cesarean section. A vaginal breech delivery should be conducted by a skilled obstetrician along with an organized team consisting of a skilled anesthetist and a neonatologist. And vaginal manipulative delivery may be done by a skilled person with a almost gentleness, and especially during the delivery of the head, there should be a skilled person must be there when the delivery of the head occurs. All these measures, if we adopt, we can prevent the fetal hazards. Next, identification of the next antenatal management. Antenatal management including identification of the complicating factors, formulation of the line of management, elective cesarean section, vaginal breech delivery and external cephalic version. So first, identification of complicating factors. It can be detected by clinical examination, supplemented by sonography. Sonography is particularly useful to detect any congenital malformation of the uterus, fetus, the precise location of the placental site and congenital anomalies of the uterus. So we can identify any complicating factors by the sonography. Next is cephalic motion. You already studied in the previous class about the external cephalic motion, indication, procedure, preliminary benefits and causes and failure of motion, dangers and management. So we can do the external cephali portion. Next is the elective caesarean section. So that elective caesarean is pre-planned. That's indications of caesarean in breech delivery are: if it is a big baby more than 3.5 kg, hyperextension of the head. Head if it is hyperextended. This is hyperextended. Then footling presentation, risk of cord prolapse. There is a chapter risk of cord prolapse, there is, which is footling presentation, and suspected pelvic contractions or severe IUGR, and any associated complications, such as obstetrical or medical, is often considered for the cesarean section in the breech. So these are the elective cesarean section indication. Next is the management of vaginal breech delivery. So criteria to be fulfilled before the vaginal breech delivery are: average fetus weight should be 1.5 to 3.5 kg and flex fetal head, adequate pelvis without any medical or obstetrical complication, availability of facilities for emergency cesarean section, that is anesthetics and neonatals must be there, and facilities for continuous labor monitoring, preferably electronic fetal monitor, and presence of obstetrician experience with vaginal breech delivery and frank breech is also preferred. Next, first stage, what are the management should be done? We should do the vaginal examination at the onset of labor for the pelvic assessment, and soon after the rupture of membrane, you have to do the vaginal examination to exclude any cord prolapse, and we have to empty the bladder. An intravenous line is cited with Ringer lactate solution. Oral intake is avoided because sometimes we go for cesarean section. That's why oral intake should be avoided. Blood is sent for the group and cross matching. So considering the chance of cesarean section, because if it fails the breech delivery, we have to post for cesarean section. That's why we have to send the blood for group and cross matching. An adequate analgesia is given, that is epidural is preferred. So if it go for cesarean section, we can introduce medicine same route and go for immediately can go for cesarean section. And fetal status and progress of labor should be monitored in the partograph. And oxytocin infusion may be used for the augmentation of labor. These are the first stage. In the second stage, there are three methods of vaginal breech delivery used: spontaneous, assisted breech, and breech extraction, that is partial or total. Spontaneous expulsion of fetus occurred with very little assistance, that is a spontaneous breech delivery. Assisted breech delivery, the delivery of the fetus is by assistance from the beginning to the end. The method should be employed in all cases. And breech extraction, when the part of part or the entire body of fetus is extracted by the obstetrician, that is a breech extraction. Indications are delivery of the second twins after internal vaginal version and cord prolapse, and extended legs arrested at the cavity or at the outlet. So this is the second stage management. Next we can see the assisted breech delivery following management. The following are to be kept ready beforehand, that is, there should be an anesthetist to administer anesthesia and when required, and an assistant to push down the fundus during the contraction, and instruments and the suture material for episiotomy. A repair of obstetrical forces for the after coming head if required, that is obstetrical forceps. Then appliances for resuscitation of the baby if asphyxiated, and there should be a neonatal. These are the following things should be kept ready beforehand. And the principles of contraction is never to rush and never pull from below but push from the above. We can push from the above, do not pull from below. Always keep the fetus with the back anteriorly. Anterior means up. Okay. These are the principles of conduction and following to be kept ready beforehand. Then the patient is brought to the table when the anterior buttocks and the fetal anus are visible. She is placed in the lithotomy position when the posterior buttocks distance the perineum. Then the avoid iotocaval compression. The woman is tilted laterally, that is 15 degree tilt, using the wedge under the back. She should be tilted to one side to prevent the aortocaval compression. An antiseptic cleaning is done. Bladder is emptied with an in and out catheter. And pudendal block is done along with the perineal infiltration if not epidural has been used earlier. If it is given early, there is no need of pudendal block. Then episiotomy should be done and patient is encouraged to bear down. Then soon after trunk up to the umbilicus is born. You can see up to the umbilicus the trunk is born. The following are to be done. The extended legs in frank bridge are to be decompressed by the pressure on it. You can see he is applying the compression on the knees, that is the popliteal fossa, in a manner of abduction and flexion of the thighs. So the umbilical cord is to be pulled down to the to avoid the traction. So it can be pulled down to avoid the traction. And if the back remains posterior, it is in the anterior. You can see from this picture, this is anteriorly. If it is posterior, rotate the trunk to bring the back anterior. Sacro-anterior position can be bring. And the baby is wrapped with the sterile towel to prevent slipping when held by the hands and to facilitate manipulation. So when the body port is out from the vaginal canal, so we have to wrap with a towel to avoid slipping. Then delivery of the hands. The assistant is to place a hand over the fundus. Okay, this is the other. So she has to keep a hand on the fundus. Keep a steady pressure during the uterine contraction to prevent extension of the arms. You can see this here, they are using the soon after the anterior scapula is visible. The position on the arm should be noted and the arms are flexed. You can see from like this, you can flex the arms up. And the vertebral border of the scapula remains parallel to the vertebral column, then extended. There is a winging of the scapula, can be seen. So this, like this, the legs, hands should be flexed. The arms are delivered one after the only when one axilla is visible. After one axilla is visible, only we have to deliver posteriorly, then anterior. It is immaterial as to which the arm is to be delivered. Delivered first, baby should be held by the feet over the sterile towel while the arms are delivered. You can see from this picture, it is covered by the delivery. After the baby is delivered, baby is covered. Delivery of the head. When the back has been turned, the infant is allowed to hang from the vulva without support for 1 to 2. Like this, the baby has to allow to hang through the vulva without any assistance for 1 to 2 minutes. The baby's weight bring the head on the pelvic floor on which the occiput rotate forward. The sagittal suture is now on the anteroposterior diameter of the outlet. You can see this is the anteroposterior diameter of the outlet, the sagittal suture. And gradually again neck elongates, the hairline appears and the suboccipital hinges can be felt. And this after the for the delivery of the head, we can use different methods. So methods of delivery after coming head are Burns Marshall method. Burns Marshall method, we already allowed the to hang in the pressure. So baby is allowed to hang itself on its weight and assistant is asked to give suprapubic pressure. You can see from this picture, it is giving the suprapubic pressure with the flat of the hand in the downward and backward direction. The pressure is to be extended more on the syncytial. Here is a syncyput, so we are giving pressure on the syncyput. When the nape of neck is visible under the pubic arch, you can see under the pubic arch, baby is grasped by the angles. You can see from the picture, they grasped by the angle with the finger in between two. You can see in finger in between two, like this we are hanging and made in a steady traction forming three traction and forming a wide arc on the circle. I can see like this, we are making a sturdy triangle, swinging upward and the forward direction. Meanwhile, the felt hand guard up, we have to guard the perineum, other hand, and slipping the perineum off successfully, the face brow or will slipping the perineum. When the mouth is clean with vulva and there should be no hurry, mucous mouth and pharynx is clean with the mucous sucker. You can see from this picture, this is your delivery. Okay, and the trunk is this depressed to deliver the rest of the heat. This is the Burns Marshall method. Next method, we can use the forceps, that is obstetrical. With obstetrical forceps like this, we can remove the baby. So same this method is using, but also assisted with the forceps. Next is the malar flexion and shoulder traction, that is modified Meriggio's Melly Volt manual. So this is also one of the method. The baby is placed in on this supinated left forearm. So if the baby she is like this, we have to allow the baby to baby placed on the supinated forearm. We can hold the forearm, two fingers and the mouth. You can see two fingers on the mouth or either side. Okay, so limbs are hanging either side of the and middle and index finger. You can see middle and index finger on the left hand are placed on the over the malar bones at the either side, and this maintains flexion of the head. You can see. Okay, so this is hang in the hand. So just now I'm showing with my right hand. So really it is in the left hand. Okay, hanging placed over the malar bone either side, then made in a flexion of the head, and the ring and index finger, little finger of the prominent right hand are placed on the child right shoulder. So other fingers, the right hand's ring and this finger, both are placed on the baby's head, okay, shoulder, and then the finger is placed on the left shoulder. The middle finger is placed on the suboccipital region. Okay, this is inside. You can hold like this. Okay, and the traction is now given downward and backward direction, and the nape of neck visible under the pubic gland. And an assistant can be given suprapubic pressure. You can see one left hand is placed here and right hand in the pubic subpubic ankle and the scapula. They are giving the pressure, and downward traction is giving, and the traction is now given in the downward and backward direction till the nape of neck is visible under the pubic arch. The assistant gives suprapubic pressure during the period to maintain the flexion. Thereafter, the fetus is carried in upward and forward direction toward the mother's abdomen, releasing the face, brow, and lastly the trunk is depressed to release the occiput and the vertex. This is the Meriggio's Melly Volt techniques, or this is the malar flexion and shoulder traction method. Next is the resuscitation of the baby. The baby may be asphyxiated and need to be resuscitated. You already knows about the resuscitation. Next is in the third stage. The placenta is usually expelled out soon after delivery of the head, and if prophylactic ergometry is to be given, it should be administered intravenously with the crowning of the head. Same as in the normal delivery. So that's all about the breech presentation. So if the position usually occurred in the left sacrum anterior, left sacrum posterior, right sacrum anterior, and right sacrum posterior. So till now we discussed about the breech presentation, different types, its causes, etiology, and its management in the first, second, and third stage of labor. That's all about today's topic. Thank you.